All right, let's pray. All right, thank you, Lord, for gathering us here. I pray that the children will have fun today as we do the activity, and also as we learn a bit more about the kings and the bad examples we see, and Lord, that they would not listen to you and they went into captivity. So we just pray, Lord, for this lesson. Pray that the children would be attentive, and we ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, a reminder again, sit quietly. Number two, that's right, shh. Pay attention when the bishop's talking. And if you want to say something, what do? Oh, so you said something without putting your hand up. Ah, okay. So Simon, what do? If you want to talk, you put your hand up. Okay, we're getting better at that one. Okay, so we're going to go over these books again. We did look at 2 Kings and 2 Chronicles, so we're going to learn a bit more about it. I'll just tell you a bit more about the kings of Israel and Judah, and particularly how the story ends when they go into captivity because they didn't listen to God. They didn't obey God. There's many times where they disobeyed God, and God eventually sent them into captivity because they weren't doing what God said. What's this a picture of? Who remembers what king we looked at last week? We looked at King Solomon. Do you remember? Remember Solomon? He built the temple. He did great works for God. He was very wise, but he did a lot of bad things as well. Remember, he had 1,000 wives. You know, he did things like that. He built temples for his wives, and he caused Israel to go into idolatry. So because of that, God said he's going to take away 10 tribes from the nation of Israel. So before, how many tribes were there? 12. 12 tribes of Israel. But because Solomon did all these wicked sins in Israel, God said, hey, he's going to take away 10 from Solomon, and he's going to give it to Jeroboam. And then there'd be two. There'd be Benjamin and Judah that would be left to be ruled by Rehoboam, his son. So how did God accomplish this? Well, after Solomon died, Rehoboam and Jeroboam, they got together to decide who was going to be king. And this is Rehoboam here. And the old man said to Rehoboam, you know, when Solomon was king, he made our life really hard. And he says, if you ease up on the people a little bit, hey, the people will serve you. So what did Rehoboam do? Did he listen to the old wise counsel of the old men? No, he didn't, did he? He went and asked his young friends, what do they think? And you know what they said? They said, don't listen to them. You know, let's make their life hard like it was before. And who did Rehoboam listen to? Did he listen to the old wise counsel, or did he listen to the young foolish counsel? Which one do you think, Simon?
The young one.
Yeah, he listened to these guys. And because he listened to them, that's how God used this situation. These guys forsook Rehoboam and they followed Jeroboam, 10 of the tribes, instead. Unfortunately, Jeroboam was a very wicked king. He ended up making 2 golden calves for them to worship because he was worried that people would go back to Jerusalem to worship the true God at the temple. And this is what split the kingdom. This is what split the kingdom of Israel into the northern kingdom of Israel and the southern kingdom of Judah. So the capital back then was in Shechem, and the capital of Judah back then was Jerusalem. Jeroboam ruled over the northern kingdom of Israel, and Rehoboam, which was Solomon's son, ruled over the southern kingdom of Judah. And like we said, Jeroboam ended up being a very wicked king because he was worried that because the temple was in Jerusalem, that Israel would go and their heart would go and follow Rehoboam because the temple was in Jerusalem. So what he did is he built 2 idols. He built 2 golden calves for them to worship. And that was the start of many evil sins and wicked kings in the nation of Israel. And this is why it was divided. So before it used to be one kingdom, but because of Solomon's sins, it split into 10 and 2. Rehoboam kept ruling over Judah, and that was the line of Jesus Christ. Jeroboam ruled in the northern kingdom. Here's a bit of a genealogy of the kings and how it works through the Bible, so we won't go through it all in depth. But you see here, remember how we learned about King Saul up here? So it started with King Saul, and then they died in the battle. The only son of Saul that was left was Ishbosheth. So because of Saul's rebellion, do you remember the kingdom was given to David? And David was a man after God's own heart, but he wasn't perfect either. You remember that he committed adultery and he murdered Bathsheba's husband, Uriah. Solomon was David's son. So because of Solomon's sins, the kingdom was split between Rehoboam and Jeroboam, right? And then you see the kings come down, and this was the nation of Israel, this northern kingdom. This line was the nation of Judah, down here. Now the nation of Israel had all wicked kings. Probably the closest one that was maybe righteous was Jehu, but he didn't end well either. So Jehu was used to kill off Ahab's house. Ahab was married to Jezebel. You remember with Elijah, and the prophets of Baal? You remember that story, Simon? So this is here. So we see when we get down to Ahab and Jehoshaphat, there was a bit of a joining here, wasn't it? Why? Because Jehoshaphat's son was married to Jezebel's daughter. So there was a bit of a truce here between the two nations. But other than that, they didn't always work together. So in Israel, there was a lot of wicked kings. Ahab is a famous one. Jehu did a lot as well. And then eventually you get down to Hosea when the nation of Israel went into captivity. Here, Rehoboam was Solomon's son. And then you have a few kings. But here we have some very famous righteous kings. For example, Jehoshaphat was quite righteous. We see here as well. Hezekiah came later and he cleaned up Israel and got them observing the Passover again. And Josiah as well, he broke down all the houses of the idolaters and the sodomites in Israel. But eventually they didn't listen to God, and then when we get to Jehoiachin and Zedekiah, that's when they were brought into captivity. So throughout this timeline, God sent prophets to tell the nation of Israel and the nation of Judah to obey God, to believe God. But unfortunately, they didn't. Look at what it says here in 2 Kings chapter 17, verse 14. Notwithstanding, they would not hear, but hardened their necks. What does it mean? I want to listen. You know, sometimes when you get angry, you harden your neck. Harden their necks, like to the neck of their fathers that did not believe in the Lord their God. So because of that, God sent them into captivity. Let's read this together. You ready? 2 Kings chapter 17, verse 14. Notwithstanding, they would not hear, but hardened their necks, like to the neck of their fathers that did not believe in the Lord their God. You see, they hardened their necks. And God was trying to get them to obey, to do the right thing. Instead of humbling themselves and obeying, they hardened their necks and they said, no, we don't want to listen to God. So eventually God said, all right, that's enough. And he sent them into captivity. So what happened? With Israel, a few hundred years before, Israel went into captivity by the Assyrians. And a few hundred years later, Judah went into captivity by the Babylonians. So this is where Nebuchadnezzar comes into the story. So Nebuchadnezzar's army came in, and look at what they did. They destroyed Judah and the temple, and they burnt it down. And they brought all the people of Judah into captivity because they would not listen to God. All right, so what do we learn from this? See, we don't listen to God either. You know, we sin, don't we? And when we sin, what happens? We're in bondage to sin. We're in captivity. But we have a Savior who can save us from captivity, Jesus. See, so just like they went into captivity, one day they were brought back and they were saved out of captivity. We can be saved out of captivity if we put our faith on Jesus Christ. Because in our own lives, we don't listen to God either. You know, we sin, don't we? Yeah, we sin all the time. But thank God we have a Savior that can save us out of captivity. So today, we've got an activity to remind us not to go into captivity. Who knows what these are? These are handcuffs. So we're going to make some paper handcuffs today. Just like they did not listen, they went into captivity. Yeah, maybe I can put it on timer. Let's have a look. So we're going to make some paper handcuffs, like this. Ah, see? There you go. Yeah. Okay, so let's stand up. We're going to go to the back, and I'm going to show you how to make a pair of handcuffs. We learned about the captivity today. Okay, let's go to the back.